That weight class was won by Eleanor Roosevelt. Maissa Taylor defeating Lisa Mendez. Next on the mat is the 120 weight class. Once again, we have Eleanor Roosevelt contesting Northwestern. /122 and counting. Second period, still in this 120 weight class. Fanny of Roosevelt leading Enriquez of Northwestern, 10-2 in this second period. 40 seconds remaining in this second period. The Raider has a substantial lead, 12-2. And gets the pin in this 120 weight class. Next weight class looks like it will be the 126 weight class from Northwestern, Albert Giovanni. And from Eleanor Roosevelt, Josiah Luck. Again, the 126 class. Once again on the mat, it's the 126. Luck from Roosevelt and Giovanni from Northwestern. Wildcat takes the early lead. Trying to get a wrist control on the Raider. Won't let him get up. Roosevelt desperately trying to get an escape here. That's the end of the first period. Wildcat leading. As we start this second period. One minute remaining in this second period. The Wildcats still leading. Giovanni building up points as we go. Leading 11-0. Once again, this is the 126 weight class. Up next will be the 132. Under 30 seconds remaining in the second period. Wrestlers will restart after being outside the circle, out of bounds. Giovanni still gaining control, about 3 seconds left. And that's the end of the second period. Final period. Roosevelt chooses the top position. Raiders get two quick points. Northwestern gets the pin. Giovanni of the Wildcats gets the win at the 126 weight class. Folks, you'll notice that there are several weight classes that we'll be skipping around, and those will be weight classes that are not fielded by the opponent. on the mat appears to be the 145 weight class. Mejia of Northwestern. Northwestern gets 2 points against Duncan of Eleanor Roosevelt. Correction, Dinan. That's Henry Dinan of the Raiders in there. Again, the 145 weight class. Coming up on 30 seconds left in this first period. Wildcats holding on to a 2-point lead in this first period. As time is winding down. And that's the end of the first. And Dinan get into their second period. Northwestern gets the pin at 1 minute, 46 seconds into the second period. Next on the mat will be the 152-pound weight class. And again, folks, whenever the opposing team does not have that weight class, that will go down as a forfeit. That will conclude the first match of the day between the Eleanor Roosevelt Raiders and the Northwestern Wildcats. We'll be back shortly. Sports starts on March 1st. Softball, baseball, girls and boys lacrosse, tennis, track and field, and unified track. Register via Form Relief, upload your physical, and have a 2.0 or better. See you in the spring.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the state duels. This evening, the second match will face the number 3 Flowers Jaguars versus the number 6 Eleanor Roosevelt Raiders. Tonight, we will be recognizing, however, these seniors from both schools, starting with the Raiders. Miss Sydney Blackwell, congratulations. Mark Hawkins, another class of 23. And last but not least, a two-time state champion, Aray Matumpe. Congratulations, Raiders. And this senior from Flowers, escorted by Michelle Floyd, Anthony Harrington. Congratulations. It's time we will begin the competition. Again, the number 6 Raiders and the number 3 Jaguars. First weight class will be the 170-pound weight class.
First on the mat will be Ogungle from Flowers. And Sosa Chavez from the Raiders. Ashton Arungle of Flowers quickly gets the Roosevelt wrestler down to the floor, down to the mat. And at 1 minute, 32 seconds, the Jaguars get the pin. Ogunlade gets the pin for the Jaguars. Next up will be the 182-pound weight class. Jaguars lead the team competition 6-0. Once again, a 182-pound class. Michael Peters of the Jaguars was on that state finalist team. We'll be facing Jordan Porter of the Raiders. Getting the clock started properly, and they're at it. Peters takes Mr. Porter down to the mat. Peters gets the pin at the 128 mark. Giving Flowers another six, leading the Raiders 12-0 in the team scoring. Looks like the 195 weight class will be a forfeit for the Jags. That'll take your score to 18-0. 220 will be the next weight class. And looks like the 220 class was also a forfeit. Next on the mats will be the heavyweights at 285. Mm-hmm. 285. That's Adam Gorusi of the Jaguars. And Matamba of the Raiders. Matamba and Adegorusi moving around, trying to get some good position. Under a minute remaining in this first period, trying to get some. Matamba gets a takedown at Gorusi. Raiders take a quick 2-1 lead. About 19 seconds left in this first period. And at the end of the first period, Raiders lead 2-1 in this 285-pound match. Tied up 2-2 at Gorusi. Gets an escape. Gets 1 point. At Gorusi gets the takedown. And gets the pin. And Gorusi battled back well in that match. Competitive match by the two heavyweights. Jaguars will go up in the team standing 30-0. Raiders will receive a forfeit in the 106 weight class. Jaguars did not field that class. The score will be 30-6 in the team scoring. Next weight class is 113 pounders. And they're just checking into the table. For the Jaguars, Anton Ajay. Masai Taylor for the Raiders. Ajayi trying to get control here. Ajayi takes a 2-point lead. The Raiders are able to get up to his feet. We'll get a point. Two to one. 1:11 left in this first period. Jai has control. Under a minute left and out of bounds. Jaguars leading 4-1. And folks, excuse me for the scoreboard. We'll get that worked out. After the first match, we were not able to change it to Northwestern, but as you can see on the mat is the Roosevelt and Flowers matchup. Taylor trying to hold on for positioning. Jai trying to get him turned. And if the Raiders can release, he'll get a point. Four to two. With about 3 seconds left in this first period. And that's the end of the first period, folks. Jaguars leading 4-2. Taylor able to get out again for that one more point. 4-3, 1 minute left in the second period. Again, we're here at the 113-pound match. between Taylor of Eleanor Roosevelt and Ajayi of C.H. Flowers. C.H. Flowers leading by a narrow 1 point. Under 30 seconds to go in this first, in his second period, excuse me. Raiders get a quick 2 points as the period ends. Third and final period. Jaguars lead 6-5 in this 113-pound match. Ajayi trying to stand up and get a release, try to get a point here. Taylor is trying to maintain control. Jai gets an important 2 points with 1 minute left, leading 8-5. Gives away a point right there with the release. 8-6 is your score under a minute. Jai desperately trying to get him to the ground. Neutral. It's getting a bit intense. They're under 30 seconds left. It's an 8-6 score. Roosevelt gets the takedown. 8-8. Just about 20 seconds left in the contest. Third and final period, tie score. He's trying to get him onto his shoulders. Taylor is. Taylor does get the final 2 points right at the end of that match, giving the Raiders and himself a 10-8 win, bringing the team score to now 30-12. Competitive match in that 113-pound weight class. At 120. We will have, from the Jaguars, London Harps, and from the Roosevelt Raiders, we'll have Harps and Fanyi trying to figure out their first move they're going to do. Fanyi shoots, trying to get Harps down. And they get each other out of bounds. The Raider getting 2 points for that takedown. .107 left. Two more points. The Raider leading 4-0 against the Jaguar Harps. The Raiders do get that pin at the 120 weight class. Next up will be the 126 class. Jaguars Javon Jackson representing the 126-pound class. And from the Raiders, Josiah Luck representing the Raiders in this 126-pound weight class. Jaguars get 2 points on that takedown. Jackson trying to get that wrist control. One minute remaining in this first period. Jaguar has him in good position to try to get this pin. 25 seconds left. And Jag gets the pin at the 15-second mark. Jackson gets the win, helping the Jaguars take a 36-15 lead in the team scoring. 132 is on the docket. And it looks like from the Flowers will be Anthony Harrington, and from Roosevelt will be Leo Foreman. Both wrestlers trying to feel each other out. See what move they can use to get some points here. A minute in, about 50, under 50 seconds to go in this first period. Harrington gets a takedown. That'll earn him 2 points. 10 seconds left in this first period. And as they get out of bounds, there'll be about 4 seconds remaining. Working on an equipment change here. 4.2 seconds left. The dual state wrestling format breaks the teams into brackets. We are in the 4A South. Continuing with this 4 seconds left in this first period. Raiders earn a point. Harrington leading 2-1 as we begin the second period. Again, there are 3 other sites, including this site, where matches are being contested over at Bowie High School. The Suitland Rams are battling over in Bowie. Henry Wise is also a host, as well as Laurel High School. Winners of each of these contests will advance and meet up on Thursday. Harrington gets him down to the mat and gets the pin. At the 127 mark, Harrington gets the pin for the Jags. Jags will take a 42-15 lead in the team standings. Thank you. We are now at the 138-pound weight class. Wrestlers are now going to the table. Raiders are represented by Ethan Lilly. And for the Jaguars, Jasheer Blue on the mat at the 138 match. Both wrestlers feeling each other, trying to get some control. Just under a minute in this first period. No score in this 138-pound class. Both wrestlers desperately trying to get some points here. Blue takes a look at the clock on the far wall, trying to get control of Lilly. Coming up on 10 seconds, Blue does get 2 points. And that's the end of the period. Excuse me for not having the correct period. We are in the second period. Blue gets the reversal, earning himself 2 points. So 4-0 early in the second period. After the restart, Blue will take the top position. Coming up on 1 minute. Raiders get a point out of that slight release. coming up on 10 seconds in this second period. Blue leads 4-1. Raider trying to get to his feet and get released. Blue does have some good control of him. Look. Under a minute left in this third period. And Blue has good control of Lily in this 138-pound match here. Blue trying to get him turned. Under 20 seconds left in this third period. And Blue will win this contest by points 4-1. Coming to the mat, the 145-pound weight class, Kamzi Ogugu of the Jaguars will face off. Against Jennifer Diebo of the Raiders. So that's Diebo of the Raiders versus Ogugo of the Jaguars, 145-pound weight class. trying to make some adjustments to the headgear. And we'll be back. About 1:20 left in this first period. Oh, Google trying to get some control. The Raiders get two on that takedown. Diobo. Jaguar picks up a point. Diobo still leading 2-1. Jaguar picks up two for the takedown. After one, Jaguars lead the Raiders in this one, 45-pound match, 3-2. Ogugu leading Diobo. Diobo, 3-2. The official giving some clear instructions. Coming up on a minute in this second period. Ogugu desperately trying to get the Raider turned. Under 30 seconds left. Ogugu leading just by a point. Looks like he's trying to get the Raider turned. Four seconds left. Diobo hangs on. Diobo of the Raiders has a good hold on the Jaguar. Ogugu gets the pin for the Jags. Next on the mat will be the 152-pound weight class. Okay, on the restart, 152 class, Genyeyi and Golson. It's Moses Agenvivi and Kennard Golson of the Raiders. The Raiders gets a turn and gets the Jaguar on his back. He's desperately trying to get this pin for the Raiders. And he does. 152, Kennard Golson gets the win in the 152 class. Moving up to the 160 class, ladies and gentlemen. The team standings, Jaguars lead 51-21. At 160, the Jaguars will have Mr. Daniel Patrick. They just finished checking in to the table, and Roosevelt will have Mr. Mark Hawkins. Early action by both wrestlers trying to gain some control. Hawkins with a little bit more length than the Jaguar, trying to get him down. No points on that takedown. Didn't actually get the wrestler all the way to the mat. 2 points for the Raider, and he gets the pin. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the last match of this evening. Jaguars 51, Raiders 27. Jaguars will advance, will travel to Laurel this Thursday. We'll give you more information. Should be a 5:30 match, but we do thank those of you who sat with us and watched this first live stream of our wrestling program today. Again, the MPSSA State Duels, which featured the number 3-seeded Jaguars, the number 6-seeded Raiders, and the number 11-seeded Northwestern Wildcats.